Hi, my name is Marcy Jacqueline. I'm the Biological Sciences Librarian, and this video is about using the SuperSearch database to find journal articles. You can find the SuperSearch box on the library homepage, www.brocu.ca/library. And the example I'm going to be using is developmental biology and phenotypes. So when we click on search, we get a large number of results, and there are various ways of narrowing the search down so that you're getting more precise results. In this case, I have an author I'm also looking for, so I'm going to use the advanced search key, and that's going to allow me to put the author's name and limit to the author field and search. And also I can limit by a few other factors, even though there's only 14 left, but it's easier to limit than to scan through them. So I know it's written in the early 1990s, so I'm going to update the date and narrow it down to a smaller date range, 1993 to 1997. The article is actually written in 1993. And I'm going to select peer-reviewed or scholarly articles and update the search, which has left me with three results. And here's the article I was looking for. And what I want to do now is to use the Get It key to find out if we have a copy available through the library, either in print or electronic. So I'm going to click on the Get It key, and that gives me a listing of where it might be available. In this case, it is full text electronic from this database and also from this electronic database. If it wasn't available in our library in electronic form, you might want to check the library catalog to see if it's available in print. And another option that would have shown up if it wasn't available is the ability to transfer the information to our interlibrary loan system, and you could request a copy through that service to be delivered to you at Brock from another location. But this is available in full text, so I'm going to click on the JSTOR complete link, and that pops up a screen. And I'm able to view this article now in full text, and you can see that it is quite lengthy, and I'm going to go over the features of a scholarly journal article. Okay, first, they do tend to be longer than magazine articles, and there are certain features here that I'd like to point out. The author is always listed, and also their credentials, where they're working. It gives you some clues as to the kind of research they're doing. There's often an abstract because the article is so long. And as we flip through the pages, we can see there's a lot of detail, background information, charts, diagrams, an indication that this has been some kind of original research. And as we move through the article, we'll see a lot of very detailed information. At the end of the article, we'll see that for this particular case, the author is acknowledging assistance, as well as some financial assistance that they received, and also a long list of references. So this paper has many of the features of a scholarly peer-reviewed article, even though the actual information about being peer-reviewed is not mentioned. In some papers, they'll give you dates that indicate when the article was received by the publisher and when it was accepted, which means that there was a time period when it was sent out to peers for their comments and assessment of the article as to its quality and acceptability. And at that point, the publisher will make a decision whether or not to publish it. And this is referred to as a peer-reviewed process.